Okay, then can we start the class now? My screen is visible and my audio is clear, right?
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Yes, okay then. Good evening, one and all guys. Today we will deal with another important floriculture loose flower. What do you mean by loose flowers?
Those flowers which are harvested just below the calyx without the stem.
Yes, those are all called loose flowers. Well, the main purpose of loose flowers are mainly for the religious offerings, like in the temple, churches, mosques. They are used, and mainly they are used in the marriages and other rituals. And another important one is they are used in the making of veni, gajra, corsage, earrings, then flower bangles. Then apart from this, making of garland also very important. Then the floral decoration like clocks, rangoli, for that also they will use. Then for the soap and perfumery industry also, this is also very important. Mainly the bouquets are made out of cut flowers. Today we will discuss one of the important loose flower, that is jasmine. Among the loose flowers, the jasmine covers the maximum area in India. Apart from jasmine, the marigold, chrysanthemum, tuberose are also very important in loose flower. The main leading areas in the loose flower production are Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, then Gujarat. The main is Tamil Nadu with respect to production. Then with respect to the area wise is also Tamil Nadu stands first. Then this jasmine is one of the oldest fragrant flower in the world. Then mainly it is cultivated in the Southeast Asian countries like India, Sri Lanka, Singapore. It has a immense potential of export value. This jasmine word is derived from a Persian name. Yasim means fragrance. This is important with respect to the exam. Persian word means fragrance. Then Tamil Nadu is the highest area where the jasmine is produced and the highest area covered. Then mainly it is used in the making of garlands, then air adornments, then for the religious purpose. One more major is making of perfumery oil concretes. This is called veni. This is mainly used to adore the hairs in the South Indian. Coming to major species, Jasminum sambac, Arabian jasmine. Then Jasminum auriculatum, this is mullai. Then Jasminum grandiflori, Spanish jasmine, or also called as pitchy. Then Jasminum multiflora, this is star jasmine or kakda. These are the important species of jasmine. Jasminum sambac, auriculatum, grandiflora, multiflora. They will mainly ask the Arabian jasmine, which among the following is Arabian jasmine? Jasminum sambac, auriculatum, grandiflora. This will be the options. So you remember this vernacular name of this species. Then the yellow flower yielding species like Jasminum humuli. This is the yellow jasmine. Then Jasminum raveltium. Then pink bearing species also there. Then red color bearing species also there. But this yellow color bearing species is very important. Then coming to ecotypes. Ecotype means mainly it is differentiated from the where the this cultivar is originated. Like Gundu Mallige, this is triploid species. Then single mogra, double mogra, these are all the ecotypes, not the varieties or the hybrids. These triploids are important. This is a single mogram, double mogram. Then in the Jasminum auriculatum, we'll find long point, long round, medium point, short point. These are all the some of the important echo types, not the varieties. Then in the Jasminum grandiflora, we'll observe pin type, thrum type, Bangalore type, then Coimbatore type. These are all the ecology. These are all the area or the ecology where this cultivar is grown. This echo type is grown. Then coming to the varieties, Perimuli, this comes under auriculatum. This is a clonal selection. The important aspect of this Perimuli variety is resistant to gall mite. This is very important. Then Co1 Mulai and Co2 Mulai. This belongs to auriculatum. Then Jasminum grandiflora. This is also called as pitchy. Here also Co1, Co2 is there. Not, they will not ask Co1 and Co2. Then Arca Surabhi. This is very important. This belongs to Jasminum grandiflorum. This is mainly used for the concrete extraction. The speciality of this is tolerant to drought condition. They will ask the Jasminum grandiflora belongs to Arca Surabhi belongs to grandiflorum species and mainly used for the concrete extraction. Sometimes they will ask, this is the speciality of the variety, tolerant to drought condition. Then Arca Aradhana belongs to Sambac group. Then this is good for the extraction of oil as well as the fresh flower also. These are all developed from IHR. Arca Arpana, this belongs to pubescence. This is also very important. The flowers are aromatic and pink colored. These are all most preferred in the South India. Arca Arpana, you remember this. Pubescence, belongs to pubescence group. This also have the attractive foliage and ornamental value. This can be used in the landscaping. With respect to the propagation, mainly done by cuttings. In the Jasminum sambac, the semi-hood or the terminal cuttings were used. This is the highest percent of survival and success rate will be more in the semi-hardwood or terminal cuttings. In the auriculatum, mainly the semi-hardwood cuttings will be used. In the grandiflorum, terminal cuttings will be used. You remember, the propagation is through semi-hardwood or terminal cuttings. Commercial propagation will be there. Then in the Tamil Nadu condition, in the May, the success rate of the rooting will be more. The plant establishment will be more. The mist encourages the rooting than the cutting. Keep under the shade without the moist. This is the common sense. This is the mist chamber used to mass multiply the Jasminum plants. After the terminal cutting kept in the cocopeat, for the root, for the enhancing the rooting and the sprouting, this mesh chamber is used. Then coming to the soil, well drained, rich in sandy loamy to clay soils are ideal for the successful cultivation of this jasmine. With respect to the planting, you all know this. Coming to the season of planting, this will differ from species to species. Usually June, July or November, December. We'll discuss this later. This is the method of planting of jasmine. I feel you all seen the jasmine plants. Apart from the net, you have seen live plants in the college or in the exhibition or in your field trips. Then the spacing also differ from species to species. I will discuss that. Then the method of fertilizer application. Nowadays, the fertigation is done, but conventionally they will go for soil application. This is the fertigation system. Venturi. This is the venturi means this is the traditionally used low cost fertigation system, majorly followed by the small holding farmers. You should remember my venture is related to fertigation system. Then use of biofertilizers, azospirillum and phosphobacterias are used in the jasminum cultivation. Then nowadays the drip irrigation is also followed. Then coming to the biostimulants. Biostimulants like panchagovya, humic acid are used at the monthly interval. These are all biostimulants. They will ask which among the following is a biostimulant: panchagovya, humic acid, and they will give some chemicals. You should remember that. With respect to the pruning, it is an important cultural operation in jasmine. The flowering habit is terminal and axillary. So we have to trim, prune the jasmine regularly to get the new flesh. Increase in the number of shoots will increase the yield. So we have to prune. The pruning influences the growth, flowering and differentiation, and finally the yield. The irrigation is withheld before the pruning. This is the common funda before pruning. We have to withhold the irrigation. Then we have to remove the past season growth. Then dead diseased parts of plant. Then all the leaves are stripped off and spray the Bordax mixture to avoid the further infection of any fungals. So this is the general process of pruning. We have to withhold the irrigation, remove the past growth, dead and decay, then remove all the leaves, then spray a Bordax mixture. Then this is the standard pruning, pruning height for the different species. For the sandbag, from the ground level, we have to prune at 50 centimeter. And for the Jasminum auriculatum, 45 centimeter. For the grandiflora, 45. And the pruning season, this is also very important. This is the last week of November for the sandbag. For the auriculatum, last week of January. Then for the grandiflora, last week of December. You just copy the same table into your short notes. This is very much important. Sandbag, November. Auriculatum, last week of January. Grandiflora, December. 50, 45, 45. Okay. You all hearing, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then with respect to the pest manage, pest management, we will discuss. The important pest will be bud borers. Then with respect to the concrete recovery, this is very much important. Conventional, usually the concrete recovery will be 0.18 to 0.19%. If you follow the precision farming, we can get up to 0.2% to 0.22%. The concrete recovery is also very much important. With respect to the harvesting, for the shorter distance market, the fresh flowers, fully developed and unopened tight bud stage. This is the tight bud stage for the shorter distance. Then for the long distance marketing, fully developed, unopened tight bud stage is the harvesting indices. For the short distance, unopened tight bud stage. For the long distance marketing, this is also fully developed, unopened tight bud stage. For the export market, we have to harvest at the early morning, at the cooler time. Then this is also for tight bud stage. Then for the concrete extraction, we have to harvest fully opened flowers in the early hours, in the cooler period. After 9:30, the concrete recovery will be reduced. Why? Because after the sun get hotter, the volatile compounds will be reduced. Then with respect to the yield, the concrete recovery will be important. For the sandbag, the concrete recovery will be 0.14% to 0.19%. This is important. The concrete recovery will be 0.14 to 0.19%. For the grandiflorum, 0.28 to 0.32%. For the multiflora, the concrete recovery is maximum, right? 0.2 to 0.3%. The highest concrete recovery is observed in Jasminum, Auriculatum or Multiflora. Jasminum, Auriculatum. The specialty of this Multiflora is it flowers throughout the year. Then these are the major jasmine concrete exporters from the India. They are mainly situated in Tamil Nadu. Then with respect to the post-harvest handling, the lesser the shelf life, the problem faced by the farmers during the peak season. Why they face the problems during the peak season? They can't handle the jasmine. This is so delicate flowers. It will lose the viability within within 1 week only. For the export, we have to be very careful. Fully developed flowers should be soaked in the chemicals like sucrose, boric acid, then copper sulfate, then silver nitrate. This is the standard formula for the export of jasmine. In the exam, they will ask, with respect to the shelf life enhancement, boric acid 4% is the best treatment to enhance the shelf life of jasmine. After the treatment, we have to keep up in the cold room. This is 7°C for the tropical species, which are not tolerant to chilling temperature. We have to keep more than 5. Then with respect to grading, we don't have any standard grades, but usually the graded according to the coral tube length, then bud size, shape, and the freshness. With respect to the packaging, this is also very important. Polythene bags with a 200 gauge for the export purpose. In gunny bags for the local market. This polythene bag will maintain the high quality and extend the shelf life of the flowers. And this packed flowers should be kept in the cool chamber where the temperature is more than 5. Then for the export purpose, CFC boxes with a 4% weight will be followed. For the export, we use CFB boxes, corrugated fiber boxes. For the local market, thermocol boxes. These are the cold storage units. These are the methods to store the jasmine flowers after the post-harvest. Temperature usually 7 to 8°C. And this relative humidity is also very important, 85 to 90%. Then in corrugated fiber boxes, properly packed for the long distance market. Then for the gunny bags will be for the local market. These are all thermocol packing. With respect to concrete extraction, this is also important. What do you mean by concrete? Concrete means it's a wax-like substance containing the natural flower perfume together with the some of the plant waxes, albumin, and coloring material. This is the wax-like substance, contains the natural flower perfume. Then for concrete extraction, how to harvest the crop, flowers. Picking of the flowers for the concrete extraction, usually done at the cooler period, like morning hours. Freshly picked, fully opened flowers will be selected. Jasminum grandiflorum has the unique fragrance. This grandiflorum has the unique fragrance. Madurai jasmine is world's best perfume, world's best concrete in the world. You have to remember Madurai jasmine. Then after the harvest, the picking of the flowers will be before 9:30 only. Then if you harvest more after the 11 a.m., the quality of the concrete will be reduced. Then after the harvesting, we have to keep in the cooler atmosphere. Then the flower should be soaked in the food grade hexane. This is the solvent. Hexane. You have to remember hexane is a solvent used for the concrete extraction. This hexane 2 liter per kg of flowers, 2 liter is added and leave for the 30 minutes to extract the perfume in the jasmine flower. then rotate the container slowly for the 20 minutes in the rotary type of extractor. The perfume subject along with the wax and the pigment dissolved in the hexane. This hexane is purified to get the concrete. Then the perfume solvent is led to the evaporator. This evaporator will heat up at the constant temperature of 75 degrees Celsius. At this temperature, the hexane will be evaporated. The evaporated solvent will be condensed in the liquid in the next glassware, which we have kept in the rotary type of extractor. This has to be remembered. The concrete extraction method is followed using the rotary type of extractor. Then the liquid containing the perfume, wax, pigments are distilled in a vacuum distillation unit with a complete removal of solvent. Then the flower concrete settled in the still is in the molten wax. This is called concrete. This has to be cooled and stored in the glass containers. Flowers has to be harvested, then dissolved in the hexane. Then we have to remove the hexane. Then the liquid will be remained. Then we have to reduce this liquid into wax, molten wax. Then we have to keep for the storage. This is called concrete extraction process. The hexane storage will be there. Then this is the rotary type of extractor. This is the condenser purification unit. Here we will mix up both. Then we will heat. We will collect the hexane in one pot and another liquid flower perfume will be collected in another pot. Then further we will distill this pot to get the concrete. This is a simple process of concrete extraction. Then this is the concrete recovery. You have to remember this. I have told you, Sambach 0.14 to 0.19. Auriculatum 0.2 to 0.28. Grandiflorum 0.2 to 0.38. Grandiflorum has the highest concrete recovery among the Jasminum species. But the best concrete will be Jasminum Sambach in the world. What is this? This is not Gajra. This is Jasminum Garland. With respect to the family, this belongs to Oleaceae. Common names will be Chameli, Mogra, Champa, Juhi. Then this is the national flower of Tunisia and Indonesia. Apart from this, Pakistan also announced that this jasmine has the national flower. You have to remember this. This is Arabic word Yasin means perfume. These are all the key points you have to remember for the, with respect to JRF point. Then these are the species: Jasminum auriculatum. And this is Jasminum grandiflorum. This is Spanish jasmine. Grandiflorum will be Spanish jasmine. They won't ask the season of flowering. Jasminum Sambach means Arabian jasmine or Tuscan jasmine. Then Jasminum multiflora means star jasmine. Then the type of fruit will be berry. You have to remember this. Type of fruit is berry. Then type of inflorescence is cymose. You have to note it down. Cymose is the type of inflorescence and berry is the fruit type. Then this is Jasminum auriculatum. Variety is Perimulli. Cowan. Then Jasminum grandiflorum. Then Jasminum Sambach. This is the fine quality of concrete we will extract from Jasminum Sambach. These are all single Mogra and double Mogra. These are all echo types. Propagation. This is the short. This is like bullet point. For auriculatum, semi hardwood cutting. Grandiflorum, terminal cutting. sandbag, terminal and semi hardwood cuttings. For the multiflorum, we'll go for suckers. Then we have discussed the spacing also, right? Okay. With respect to the spacing, jasminum auriculatum, for the auriculatum, spacing will be 1.5 into 1.5. For the grandiflorum, 2 to 1.5. Then for the sambac, 1.25 to 1.25. This is very much important. The spacing and the pruning time is very much important. This is not the pruning time. We have discussed earlier, na, that one. For the auriculatum, 1.5. For the grandiflorum, 2 to 1.5. Then for the sambac, 1.25 into 1.25. Then the pruning time, this is also very important. You have to remember this. With respect to the weeding, usually manual weeding is followed. Yield, the concrete yield, concrete recovery is very much important. This is how the local packaging will be there. This is how for the special packaging for the export, CFB boxes, corrugated fiber boxes. With respect to the plant protection, the bud borer, hendulacasis, this is very important. It will directly affect the economic part. Then red spider mite. This is also very much important in jasmine. Then with respect to disease, leaf blight is very much important, caused by Cercospora and Alternaria. Alternaria jasmine. Then this is Fusarium wilt, but this is prominent leaf blight. And yellowing of leaves is due to three factors: iron deficiency, nematode infection, and root rot. This is root rot of jasmine. Usually with the deficiency also cause the yellowing in jasmine. Then for the nematode infection also cause yellowing. Then we have discussed extraction of concrete. But hexane is the solvent. For every 1 kg of jasmine, 2 liter of hexane will be added. Second process is we have to evaporate the solvent, that is hexane. Then this is called veni, used for the air odorant, used as air odorant in the South Indian wedding functions. Then this is, you have to remember this one also. These are all the value added products of jasmine. Jasminum green tea. You will get different types of jasminum green tea, honey tea, like that. These are all the essential oils. This is also veni. This is jasmine wax. The left out after the concrete, we will purify the purify into absolute. This absolute will be exported. This is the finest part of perfume. The left out plant pigments will be converted into, what is this? Wax lamp. These are handmade soaps. This is perfumes. Then for further reference, you can read the textbook like Commercial Floriculture by T.K. Bose. Then Value Addition in Flowers by Lakshman. Then with respect to mainly India export the jasmine for Sri Lanka, Singapore, Malaysia and Gulf countries. This is very much important. We'll export the export for Gulf countries majorly. This is the oldest fragrant flower. You have to remember this. Then this is also used as a food adulterant, like yellow pigment to substitute the saffron. This is also very much important. Write it down. we have jasminum tea in the China called as jasminum flower tea. The jasminum essential oil is mainly extracted by enfleurage. This is the essential oil extraction method. For the concrete extraction, a rotary type of extractor. You have to remember this. The main chemical constituent present in the essential oil of jasmine is methyl anthonylate, indonol, benzyl alcohol. You remember this, methyl anthonylate. This is main constituent. Then largest producer of jasmine essential oil is India, followed by Egypt. But Egypt is the largest exporter of jasminum oil. We produce lot, but we will consume lot in India. With respect to the origin, Persia, usually we will say Persian region is the origin. And the species, with respect to the species also, some will say East Indies, India, like that, it will differ. This is auriculatum. In auriculatum, we will find perimoli. This is auriculatum. Then this is the national flower of Pakistan, Jasminum officinale. You have to remember this. Officinale is the national flower of Pakistan. Grandiflorum is Spanish jasmine. In this, we will observe Arca surabi variety. Important one. Then these are not that much important. Jasminum multiflora, sambac, cultivars. Arca aradhana is important under the jasminum sambac. This is the rosy pink species, Bisianum. Jasminum Bisianum. What is the specialty of this flexiles? It will also flowers throughout the year. Jasminum humula is yellow colored jasmine. Frutescens also yellow colored one. Nodiflorum. You have to note it down this. These are all yellow color producing species of jasmine. They won't ask the in detail with respect to the varieties. You remember this, Arca surabi. Arca aradhana, Arca arpana. The with respect to the cultivar, they will ask in the match the following type or in the multiple type questions. Propagation seed is very difficult. Usually vegetative propagation is followed. Layering is also done. Grafting, budding, these are all tried, not at the commercial scale. With respect to the hormonal treatment, after the selecting the terminal cuttings, we'll go for the IVA treatment, 1000 ppm. This is the general question. Every time they will ask this. This is the spacing we discussed. Pruning also very much important. Apart from the manual pruning, we'll use SADH. SADH, this is a chemical defoliant. This is alternative for manual pruning. Then psychosil at 1000 ppm. This is also very much important. Then ethyl at 1000 ppm. Ethyl, psychosil, SADH. These are all important chemical defoliants. Then you have to remember this. Glyphosate is a post-emergent weedicide. Like that, you have to remember pre-emergent weedicides and post-emergent weedicides. With respect to the major pest, we will discuss that. Tinting, this is very important. Tinting is followed in the jasmine also. Tinting is a technique used to make the colors, make the flowers colorful. This is mainly done in the garlands, strings, veni. This is mainly done. I have said concrete means it's a natural flower perfume together with the plant wax and pigments. Absolute means it is the ultimate or the fine part of concrete, volatile oil at the highly concentrated form is called absolute. The method to extract the concrete is solvent extraction method or supercritical fluid extraction method. These two important methods to extract the jasmine concrete. You have to note it down. Solvent extraction is traditional one. This is high tech. Supercritical fluid extraction method. Here, carbon dioxide is used as a solvent to extract the concrete. Then with respect to the important pest, bud borer. Bud borer is very important. You have to remember this bud borer. This will directly affect the buds. So it will cut off the yield. These are all the damage symptoms of bud borer. How to control this? Use the light traps to kill the adult moth. Then maintain the hygiene in the orchard. Then collect and destroy the damaged buds. Then rake the soil during the off season to expose the pupa. Then apply carboryl. Then you can also apply the carbofuran. Then neem seed kernel extract. This is also very important biological control. Then gallery worm. This is also important one. They will web the leaves and the flower parts. So we have to collect and destroy, use the light traps, then neem seed kernel extract, then melatonin. We have to properly prune and maintain the hygienic environment in the orchard. Then leaf webworm. This is also important. They will scrape out the green material of the leaf. So the photosynthetic activity of the plant will be drastically reduced. It will directly affect the yield. They will skeletonize the leaves by scraping the parenchymatous tissues. This is important. Skeletonize the leaf. What is this? Leaf web worm. These are all the technical words they will give in the multiple type questions. Then this endosulfan is banned now. Don't take the option. You should reject the endosulfan in any multiple choice type questions. This is the leaf roller. This is not that much important. Then jasminum eriophyte mite. This is very much important. Acaria jasmini. This is the damaging symptom. Gall like formation in the jasmine leaves. Hair like growth. The hairy outgrowth is known as eranium. This term is associated with the jasminum. What is this? Jasminum eriophyte mite. You have to remember this terminology. How to control this? Remove and destroy the affected plantlets. Then spray dicofol or wettable sulfur. Then red spider mite is also important. Then these are the signs of webbing by mites. Then tingit bug, not that much important. Then thrips, these are all the common sucking pest observed in the flowers. This thrips will be present in the flowers, so we can't smell the flowers directly through nose. They will enter into our nasal cavity. So the elders will say, don't smell the jasmine flowers harvest after the harvest. Jasmine bug. Then blossom midge. Remember this. This is the midge. The maggots will affect the flower pots. Are you there? Anuj?
Yes, sir.
Namrata?
Yes, sir.
Surya, Gayatri?
Yes, sir.
Srishti? Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
Then the chromosome number is 2N is equal to 26. You see, the native belongs to India, China, Malaysia, or Persia. You have to choose which are all the relative options you will get. If the India comes first, you have to choose India, India and China. Southeast Asia is there, you go for Southeast Asia. The type of inflorescence is cyme. Bisexual flowers. Then seeds are without the endosperm. These are also non-endospermic seeds. Likewise, orchid also. The fruit is berry, contains only two seeds. Then the factors which influence the fruit set and seed set. Mainly the seed set is the problem in jasmine. The differences in the flower phenology, then the limitation of pollen transfer. Here we'll observe pin and trim type of flowers. This is also very much important. Pin and trim type will observe in the jasmine flowers. Then fruit abortion is also major problem. So the seed set will be low. We'll observe only in the jasminum sambac. In the multiflorum, officinale, grandiflorum, these species will not set the seeds. This is mainly cross-pollinated plant by bees. Have you seen the fruit set of jasmine? Usually, the jasmine won't set the seeds. We have to cross-pollinate. We have to hand pollinate for our hybridization work. Basic chromosome number will be 13. Mainly the diploid species will be there in the jasmine. See, the jasminum bud borer and the green scale. These are all the major pest of jasmine. With respect to the breeding methods, selection, hybridization, polyploidy breeding, mutation, biotechnological work has been carried out. But the selection is the prominent one. You see, Arka Arpana, Arka Aradhana. The hybridization is complex due to non-fruit. They won't set the fruits. Then cross incompatibility is also there. Hence, the hybridization is difficult. You remember, cross incompatibility, non-fruitfulness is the major problem in the jasmine hybridization. Then under the natural condition, the seed set is very rare. This is also vary from the species to species. Only jasminum sambac will set the seeds. Then with respect to polyploidy breeding. You remember 1% colchicin is used for the polyploidy breeding. If we treat the diploid species, the resultant will be tetraploid. This will increase the size of the flowers. You remember 1% colchicin is used as a chemical agent for the polyploidy breeding. This tissue culture is not successful in jasmine. Yes, this completes the jasmine crop. If you have any doubts, you can ask now. Yes, Anuj. Anuj, Euphoria, Gayatri, Namrata, Srishti. If you have any doubts, kindly ask. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, this will complete the jasmine crop. For the next session, which part of the floriculture you want? You need cut flowers or the loose flower?
Sir, any will do.
Anyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then next class we'll deal with the gladiolus. Okay. Okay, be thorough with all these crops. I will ask some questions in the next session. Okay. This will end the today's class. Okay. Thank you for your patience. We'll end the session.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you.